No space or time.
Noun means light and it's nouns.
This means that in the universe there are locations where time stops.
Tas nozīmē, ka visumā ir vietas, kur laiks apstājas.
So although we experience time as always moving,
un kopīgi mēs pieredzam, ka laiks visu laiku virzās uz priekšu,
there is also in the universe time beyond motion.
Ir vismā arī vietas, kas atrodas ārpus laika kustības.
I'll give you one more example. If we have a wheel which is turning round,
ja mums ir rats, kas visu laiku griežas,
on the outside rim it's going quite fast.
Ārējā daļā rozās visu notaļ ātri.
But as you get closer to the center it's going more slowly.
Bet jau tuvāk centrā mēs nonākam, jo šis kustības ātrums ir mazāks.
Because it has less time to travel.
Jo ir mazāk distance.
So as you go closer and closer to the center, it goes slower and slower.
Un jo tuvāk asīm mēs nonākam, jo lēnāk ir kustība.
And hypothetically, in the very center, it stops.
Un hypothetiski pašā centrā kustība apstājas.
Of course, we can't physically find such a location.
Protams, fiziski mēs nevaram atrast šādu vietu.
But logically we can say at the center it stops.
Bet loģiski mēs varam teikt, ka centrā sātrums ir nulle.
So something similar is happening in the practice of culture.
Un kaut kas līdzīgs ir arī kultūras praksē.
I'm going to pause and invite questions.
Šajā brīdī es pats uzliku pauzi un tagad ļaušu.
Experience of empty form, it's beyond material. So it's hard to grasp or I think that any idea what is the experience that is. Pieredze, kas ir pāri materiāliem, ārpus materiālā. Tad jautājums ir par to, kas tad vispār tiek pieredze šajā brīdī. So, I would like to clarify a bit. The question is whether it is somehow distinguishable from not experiencing anything at all, and if yes, then is it possible to describe the difference?
Yeah, there's something appears. The empty form appears to the mind. It's not a complete non-appearance of anything.
No mechanic but additionals.
Level, for example, when I'm looking at the carpet, you know, I have some pleasant sensations or I like it. And this is because of my car. Like, you know, maybe if I would have a unpleasant, this is emotive kind of soul, but when I'm looking deeper and deeper, in which level karma is affecting you, and then it's like, because it's later it's only just doesn't feel so kurā līmenī tas vienkārši skaties uz formām, ja tev viņš patīk un nepatīk un viņš tev šita slīmeni sēma, ka tu tā kā viņu, ka tev vairs tā karma neiespaido tādā veidā, nu, ka tev viss ir tikai patīkams, nu, ka tev ir tev kuršo kolumbus.
So, in systemic color chakra and also other high circuit tensions, you talk about gross, subtle, and very subtle levels.
Galaktikā un citās augstākajās jau sistēmās mēs runājām par smalko, rupjo smalko, smalko līmeni.
Okay. And the gross level is definitely a karmic appearance.
Rupjākajā līmenī noteikti pastāv karmiskā parādīšanās.
That means that as a result of our previous actions, we have this life.
Nozīmē, ka mūsu karmisko darbību rezultātā mēs esam tikuši pie šīs dzīves.
As a human being.
Kā cilvēciskas būtnes.
In samsara, which has the nature of suffering.
Pieredzot samsāru, kas ir ciešanā.
And as a human being, we experience kāpēc.
Un kā cilvēciskas būtnes, mēs sastopamies ar labājiem.
Insects don't experience kāpēc. Of course, an insect can walk along that.
Protams, insects are part of it.
But the insect doesn't know it as a carpet.
But insects never use a carpet.
Because they don't have the karma for carpets.
You're me and not for carpet.
So it's true that carpets are a karmic phenomenon. It's the same for many things in the human realm. Even some animals like dogs will see not see the colors. But whether you're an insect or a dog or a human, at the very subtle level of mind, it's the same.
Bet neatkarīgi no tā, jūs esat kukaiņas suns vai cilvēks, viss smalkākajā līmenī pieredze būs tāda pati.
And this is not really so affected by karma.
Un šo smalkāko līmeni kāda īpaši neietekmē.
It's a bit like the sea.
To var pielīdzināt jūrai.
On the surface there are many waves.
Virspusē ir daudz viļņu.
It could be very calm, or it could be stormy, or it could be in between. But in the very depths of the ocean, it's always still. So the mind is like that. So when we come to this very subtle level, there are appearances.
Un, kad mēs nonākam pie smalkākajiem līmeņiem, ir kaut kādas parādības.
But for us, we don't really have any special experiences of that.
Bet mums, attiecībā uz tām nav nekāds īpašs pieredzes.
It's because our mind is obscured.
Jo mums prāts ir aptumšots.
It's because we're totally dominated by this gross level.
Your most building appearance that's obvious statements.
We do experience the very subtle level at times, but not really consciously.
Mēs reizēm mēdzam piedzīvot smalkākus apziņas līmeņus, bet parasti tas nenotiek apzināti.
For example, when we die, our mind goes into the very subtle level.
Piemēram, kad mēs mirstam šajā miršanas procesā, prāts iziet caur smalkākiem līmeņiem.
But it's doubtful that many people are really conscious at that time.
Bet mēs ticams, ka vairums no cilvēkiem to skaidri apzinās.
It is supremely peaceful.
Jā, tā sajūta varbūt ļoti mierīga.
I don't know how conscious people are unless they develop that through meditation.
Un es nezinu, cik parasti cilvēki ir apzināti, ja vien šajā brīdī, ja vien viņi nav iepriekš trenējušies meditācijā.
Your mind goes through this level as you go to sleep.
Tāpat arī mēs iziet cauri smagākiem līmeņiem, kad mēs dodamies gulēt.
So if you're a little skilled in meditation, you can stay conscious as you go through that.
Un, ja mēs esam nedaudz pieredzējuši meditācijā, tad mēs varam palikt apzināt.
Try.
Pamēģināt.
See, maybe you can have some experience of this more blissful level of mind.
Un tad mēs varam pamēģināt sajust šo sāpīgāko prātīmē.
Blissful and clear and empty.
Tas ir svētlaimīgs, tīrs un tukšs.
And really the various practices train you to sustain that consciousness.
Un daudz un dažādas prakses vienkārši trenē mums saglabāt šo apzināšanos.
And Kala Chakra is just one such system.
Un Kala Chakra ir tikai viena no šādām sistēmām.
Okay, any other questions?
That's it, okay.
What's the difference between empty
form and empty form? Kala Chakra is that push your problem.
Okay, I'm going to give you a technical answer. Empty form is empty of material particles.
Tukšā forma ir tukša no materiālā daļā.
It is form, which is normally has material particles.
And forma, bet tiek asociēta ar materiālā daļā.
But it's completely empty of that.
Bet tukšā forma ir pilnīgi tukša no materiālā daļā.
Emptiness means empty of inherent existence.
Tukšums nozīmē, tukšums no pašmaka eksistēšanas.
It means empty of existing independent.
Nozīmē, tukš no eksistēšanas neatkarīgā veidā.
So when you say the word emptiness, you have to ask, empty of what?
Kad mēs runājam par tukšumu, mums ir jājautā, tukšums no kā?
If you say the glass is empty, then it would be empty of water, for example.
Piemēram, ja mēs sakam, glāze ir tukša, tad parasti mēs esam domāt, ka tā ir tukša no ūdens.
If you say, my mind is empty, we usually mean I'm not thinking about anything.
Un, ja mēs sakam, ka mēs prāt ir tukša, tad parasti mēs esam domāt, ka mēs nedomājam.
So in this Buddhist sense, we have very clear definitions of these two terms.
Un, tāpēc Buddhist, ja mēs daudz skaidrs definicijas par kādu sakam.
Empty form is empty of material particles.
Tukšā forma ir tukša no materiālā daļā.
And emptiness in shunyata means empty of inherent existence.
Un tukšums, sanskritā shunyata, ir tukšums no pašnoteiktas eksistences.
Right. Now it's time for you to have a discussion with somebody next to you in pairs.
Un tagad ir laiks diskusijai ar cilvēku satrodas jums blakām, pārējiem.
And I want you to share some memories with your partner.
Un es gribu, lai jūs dalāties savā sapiņās ar savu partneri.
Try to remember any times in your life when you felt that time stopped.
Cenšamies atcerēties tās reizes savā dzīvē, kad mēs izjūtām, ka laiks apstājās.
Okay, and just share with your partner and try to understand what was really happening at that time.
And,